This is the Adreno Duo. It's a new board that's used for the RADS Adreno Duo Shield. Some interesting things about this new board is it has a 32-bit processor. It has pins to accept the RADS board on top, just like the Adreno Mega. It has a reset button to erase over here. And then it has a normal reset button to power cycle. We also have a native USB micro connection here. And then we have a programming micro USB connection over here. And then power if you decide to use it here. In a moment, I'll show you the RADS board that we'll use to connect to it. This is the Adreno Duo Shield board. The name for it is a RADS board, which stands for RepRap Adreno Duo Driver Shield. I'm going to point out a couple of landmarks on it. I'll go into more detail in future videos, but these actual screw-down mounts over here for wires are used for power in. Then we have two fuses that we can actually swap out if they blow. We have our Z driver mount and pins, our Y motor mount for our driver board and pins, and then our X motor mount, driver board and pins. Then we have three more driver mount for our driver boards, and that would be our extruder 1, 2, and 3. We have pins over here for our LCD. Then we also have pins for our minimum end stops, so X, Y, and Z. And then we also have maximum, if you'd like those, of X, Y, and Z. Over here we have a micro SD that's on the actual board. We also have a plug-in for your LCD over here. And within these pins, we have a spy port, I believe. And over here, we have our I2C pins for the four pins. Then these blank openings for pins, three of which are used for servos. And the fourth one is used for a ATX connection. Then we have three more pins over here that are used for the auxiliary ADC. Over here we have our auxiliary 1, which are open sets of pins, and our auxiliary 2. This can be used for adding an additional 3 steppers for extruders. And then finally, we have, let's see, on the back side of this board, but before I get there, we have our 5 sets of pins for a thermistor for either hot ends or for the bed. And then finally, on the bottom, we have our micro-stepping configuration pins. So basically these are switches that you can switch back and forth to increase the level of step. Normally you would either do 1/16th step, 1/32nd, and something new on this board, you can do 1/100th of a 28th step. So in the next portion of the video, I'll actually show you how to connect the male pins to the duo female connection, and then show you how to load a basic software load in Adreno. So hang on a sec. Okay, now that we have the duo, just keep in mind that this is our programming port. We have our male pins here and our female pins here. In order to connect them, what you're going to do is you're going to move the male pins over the female pins, apply a little thumb pressure, and there you go. They're now connected. So in the next portion, I'll show you actually how to load the firmware on this configuration. Okay, to connect to the programming port, we're going to use a micro SD, and we're going to connect to the one closest to the power supply. And then we're going to connect the other end of the USB to the computer, and you should hear a beep. Okay, we're going to navigate down to the firmware. Now the firmware we're going to use is the Marlin for Duo-Master. This is a firmware provided by the RADS in the link to their PDF. We're going to navigate down into the Marlin folder, and we're going to select marlin.ino. Now keep in mind the reason that we're using this firmware, it's not the latest and greatest, but it is stable. So we're going to navigate to the configuration.h tab. We're going to do a search on motherboard to verify that we got the right one. So it does say board underscore RADS. So a couple things we want to do. We want to check to see under tools that we have the right board selected and programming port, which is Adreno Duo programming port. And we want to make sure that we're connected to COM3, which is our board. So now the next thing to check is, I have to explain this real quick. Verify is used to compile and verify that your build is good. And then you have upload. Now upload also has verify at the beginning, and then at the end it will upload to the board. So we're going to select this one, and on the right hand side in the middle of the video, you'll see a little bar moving across the side as it compiles. As it compiles, when it completes the actual cycle across to the right, it means that it probably compiled correctly, and then it'll begin to upload. So in the black space down here where my cursor is moving, you'll actually see the load take place. It's slightly different from the Adreno Mega Ramps load. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.